that language. But before that, I wanted to say there's something called social infrastructure and physical infrastructure. Somebody said that education is social infrastructure. Hospitals, Medicare is social infrastructure. Hardcore things like airport, dam, is physical. I will talk about projects of physical infrastructure. That book that has been given is also about physical infrastructure. So we will not talk about social infrastructure. I will come back to social infrastructure and desirability, as somebody said, to the extent that it applies to money that has been invested. Okay. Mukherjee madam, you are away. What I was saying was that I want you to think from ground zero. Will you hear when I made a statement that I do not educate my daughter? What was the solution? Is it logic? Under what circumstances can you be logically correct? It's logically correct, but under what circumstances is it? I am a professor. My wife is a professional. We don't educate our daughter. Unless you guys start thinking afresh, you will start to lose money.
So it would also be.
No. You went down, she has to pay the price. Or at least she is getting all the attention. I don't have daughters. Funny, yeah, I don't have daughters. Yeah, it could also be.
It could also be that if you have daughters, maybe your daughters don't understand. You have to go for something else.
It could be, I'm glad you raised this, because in real life, in what we call practical life, it's not possible. One has to educate the children. It's a law, right, the education of the children. So, social pressure, remember these things. There's the social pressure. There's a political expediency, as we call it, which is necessary. There's social pressure, there's this thing, and there's some practicality of it. Okay? So, every child shall be educated somewhere in the world. So, while logically it made sense, practically, but for the fact that I don't have doctors, I would have to educate. Then we go on into definition of education. I teach, my wife teaches them, or I teach them how to make rotis, dal, cooking, taking care of how to do very good education. How do I sound? So, that area of it, you can go on discussing. What I wanted to say was, let us come back to physical education. Let us come back to CAPEX and recovery, which means cash outflow, cash in. So let me remove all this. You can think of how many daughters I have, and so on. Next question. Who should provide public infrastructure? आप आंसर देंगे और फटाफट छोड़ दें या
गवर्नमेंट
एनीबडी एल्स व्हाई ऑटोनॉमस बॉडीज पीएसयूज एमबीए इज पीएसयू वी शुड बिल्ड रोड्स वी शुड मेक इन रोड्स. Okay, traditionally, let me not get into that. Traditionally, yeah. You know my friend Sheersaf Suri? No, I can't be friends with such a great man. When I was a child, just like you were forced to study history, I was also forced to study history. And I was told that this king dug wells, planted trees, and made roads. My grandmother had said, anybody who write about you, write, he did this, he did this, he did this, and shares our stories, names. As a child, I was wondering, he told Raja, he should kill people, he should go on war, go on horses, elephants, you know, fight with swords and guns and things. Those are totally digging roads, making roads. Who makes roads? In those days, there was manual labor. I was thinking, a king. Anyway, question. Why did Sher Shah Suri build that? You been on that? Why did Sher Shah Suri build that? Movement of troops. There were Romans. One was for territorial protection and one was for trade. So government did that. If the government does not do this, then what happens? If the government doesn't take care of infrastructure, doesn't take care of people, give me one example. There is a historically important or very famous example of monarchy being overthrown by
Russia.
Yes, you are there. I agree. Very outstanding example. Yeah, one more. Any other example? Politics and economics go hand in hand. That's called political economy. And therefore, public infrastructure is important, and we will go to physical, like roads and things. Before we go to that, we will split this into private projects. Or in general, and this is of more interest to us, but this is what we teach in our MBA, right? Like for example, Tata Steel wants to set up a new steel plant, okay? MBA wants to set up a builder hospital. I want to buy the Rolls Royce. Like, you want to build 100 floor houses, I want to buy a house. These are all non-public projects. We take a look at them. Before we take this up, what is the thought process? Let's say I want to build, like Elon Musk, a electric. Well, I have an idea. Anybody wants to fund it? We have a diesel engine which will produce electricity which will be stored in batteries which will run this. They will be smooth like these batteries. Or we'll have individual drones from Parthenon hostel to be blocked. What is the thought process of a person or group or anything when we talk of projects?
Benefits should be maximized.
What should be maximized?
Benefits.
Benefits. To whom?
To whom? The concerned person. Supposing if it is a public project and the public at large should be.
Who's public at large?
Supposing I'm planning to construct road from Gurgaon maybe. Uh-huh. All those persons who are living in between the be
benefited. Okay, take a AK-47 and do da 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 da, they allowed that. what China has done. China has done that. Some could go and both they are आपको पीछे चले जाओ बिल बिल कर रहा
हूँ
ऐसे नहीं इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर की जरूरत है जब मोदी जी जाएंगे ए टू बी उनको बड़ा गाड़ी होगा वो चलेंगे सब चलेगा क्यों नहीं वन इज बेनिफिट्स ओके समबडी सेड कॉस्ट बेनिफिट समवेयर नो बेसिकली आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ ऑपरेशन Okay. Cost benefit. I have a problem. To who pay? When the highway was built, we both had problems. Ghar pahunchte 12 baje. People from Uttarakhand and all have a problem. Idhar se udhar jana hai, gaay ko le jana hai, idhar se udhar nahi ja sakte. सड़क पार नहीं कर सकते हैं
व्हाट
काइंड ऑफ कॉस्ट सोशल कॉस्ट मनी कॉस्ट नॉन मनी कॉस्ट ओके वी विल स्टिक टू मनी ओके कॉस्ट पर आई वांट टू व्हाट इज द थॉट प्रोसेस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिकॉग्नाइज दैट व्हेन देयर इज अ प्रोजेक्ट देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ कैन वी कॉल देम स्टेक होल्डर And therefore, when you think of appraisal, you must be very sure from whose point of view I am making sure. For example, this is our favorite discussion. Electric vehicles are good. Are they good? Can you give me a counter argument?
Common
reason. Electric rickshaw, you remove the excise duty on that, whatever GST, non-GST, whatever is the latest duty on that.
Manual labor will lose.